We have joining us live from London an African affairs analyst, Jermaine Sanwoolu. Thank you very much for joining us right now. It's been 15 years now since all those top politicians, journalists and other Eritreans have been in detention. What does it appear to you? What kind of government are we dealing with now in Eritrea?
Thanks for having me. Eritrea's government situation and governance situation is one that is very worrisome, and the all has to come together to actually resolve this issue. It all started in 2001 when they got their independence, a hard-fought one from Ethiopia, and since then it's been like if they still have that mentality of fighting to survive and keep control. Now the government, President Isasi Abreki, he's there right now, and they are using so much repression, so much oppression, and they are actually enslaving their own people. A lot of human rights activists and a lot of human rights groups have actually been shouting and clamoring and for change in that country, but it seems like if nothing is happening, it's almost like a prison state right now in Eritrea.
And then there's also speculation now that these people may have been, into forced disappearance, of course, on the orders of the government. What's your analysis as to the welfare and well-being of these people in detention?
Well, there are varied reports regarding what has actually happened to them. There are some people who come out and say that some of these men have even lost their lives. Some of them have died in imprisonment. Some of them have suffered all manner of ailments because they've been kept in confinement. Well, we know the Eritrean government, what they do is that they have, they actually commit a lot of judicial killings, alleged, and they do a lot of of people who just want to speak out. You know, people don't have liberty. The journalists have been arrested for close to 12, 15 years right now for just speaking out their own views regarding the rights of the Eritrean people. So I strongly believe that the international community has to come together, especially the AU has to actually investigate this. I'm sure you've heard of the report by the United Nations Council on Inquiry, chaired by Mike Smith, who said, you know what, that it's Eritrea is actually committing a lot of crimes, murder, rape, the government that is, just to try and repress the people. And I believe the AU has to come together and say, how are we going to intervene to try and stop Eritrea from, self-destructing and inflicting harm upon its own people.
And of course, President Isaias Afwerki's government has been touted as, next only to Korea. In fact, he's been called Africa's North Korean president, so to speak. In his defense, though, he said the actions taken now on these individuals were based on protecting national security as they posed a threat. Mr. Sanwo-Olu, definitely this desire to protect national security isn't perpetual, is it?
No, it isn't, and I believe that is just a way of covering up their insecurity. He's trying to hold on to power because, when they left Ethiopia, when they got their independence, it was a hard-fought one. And now they're trying to ensure that no division occurs in the country, no opposition rises, that they keep control of that country. And the thing has to really change. His government has to look for new ways of actually helping its people. In 2015, last year, they actually said they're going to implement some policies that will ensure that there's liberal governance in Eritrea, but it doesn't seem to be so. And I said about the UN report, it's very damning, and it's saying, you know what, Eritrea has to change its ways. Right now, they're even in a crisis. Up to 5,000 people, leave that country every month. Just in 2015 alone, they had up to 45,000 people seeking asylum in Europe because that state is like a prison state, Eritrea. And I believe right now their trading partners have to, in the international community, also their trading partners have to look at what kind of sanctions can they put in place to ensure that Eritrea actually looks at ways to actually improve the livelihood of its people. We know Canada is their major trading partner. They trade with the Saudis, with the Chinese, but they just want to have to come together and say, you know what, do good for your people, and we will keep on trading with you. If not, it's really going to be a sad story for those in Eritrea, because they are really suffering right now.
Eritrea is obviously not an island to the world. On record, it's party to the International Convention on Civil and Political Rights since 2002, the African Charter itself since 1999, and a party to the Convention Against Torture since 2014. From all you've said, do you get a feeling that perhaps the world is also to blame for the plight many are facing in Eritrea?
Well, it seems so. It seems so, but maybe unintentionally, but, you know, actions, that's what's actually happening. As I said, they have to clamp down. They have to say, you know what, take care of your people, or we'll kind of put some restrictions upon you. We know in the Horn of Africa right now, even in Eritrea, they are going through a food crisis. It's really tough in that time. And if the international community can say, you know what, you guys have to adjust, you guys have to make changes. You know, Eritrea is actually, it's not an island of itself, but it's actually the smallest African nation, but it is the most repressive in the whole of Africa. And as you said, second to North Korea, they have to cause this change. The international community, especially the AU, the UN has actually said the AU has to take a lead role in actually ensuring that Eritrea, you know, ensures that its people, human rights violations, forced imprisonments, and all these kind of crimes against humanity are actually, you know, resolved and actually sorted, because they don't need to have this kind of mindset whereby they feel they are fighting to protect.
And Sanwo-Olu, thank you very much for your analysis. Mr. Sanwo-Olu is an African Affairs analyst now.